greetings tonight. We kind of ruffled right now. I don't know, because we're doing Jamaica and gun violence. I don't know if that's the case. But anyway, my name is John Crowley, host and the producer. And tonight, we want to tackle an issue that is in our community. Gun violence in the community is something that we all are aware of. And I started out with the Jamaica National Anthem as a way of leading into the conversation that we're going to lead into the later conversation. The conversation that I want to talk about first, I have a young man here from Jamaica, and he wears a lot of hats. So tonight I'm asking him to actually wear two hats. He's going to tell me about the Jamaica Independence Ball. That's a ball where the Jamaicans come together and celebrate the nationalness of Jamaica and talking about things Jamaica and celebrating, if you will, the accomplishments of Jamaica and Jamaicans in the diaspora. Mr. Irwine Clare has been in the community, very, very active, involved with BICL, involved with a lot of different organizations. If you want to find anybody or anything, whether they're from Jamaica, Guyana, Venezuela, or Afghanistan, call Irwine. I mean, it's as simple as that. He's resourceful in every which way that you can think of, and quite knowledgeable about a lot of things. So now I find myself finding out about the Jamaica Independence Committee. What's the whole acronym?
It's actually JICF, Jamaica Independence Celebration Foundation, Inc.
Foundation, Inc., that's right. So that what they've done, and I have to say this, right? When Jamaicans do things in the Caribbean community in New York, whenever the Jamaicans do something, it is so well done. It is so well done and so well executed that I just feel so proud. I mean, I feel like I was a Jamaican. I feel like they should just adopt me. Irwine wants to be Grenadian, I want to be Jamaican, you know. And then, well, Rickford trying to be everybody else. But anyway, tell me about the event, Irwine.
It's not just about Jamaicans celebrating here in Jamaica. It's also about friends of Jamaica and wannabe Jamaicans like yourself. We have an accommodation for you, and we welcome you. And that's all part of the whole Caribbean spirit. So Jamaica does not just exist here in isolation, but it exists as part of a Caribbean experience. This is our 51st year of independence. And, you know, as you know, we are, like the rest of the Caribbean islanders, are very patriotic. And some will say we are probably more patriotic than many. But this is our 51st year of independence. And as part of the penultimate celebration here, from a perspective of culture and splendor and dressing up and looking good, is our Independence Ball. And this is not, I won't say a catch for everything, because, John, there are several other events taking place. But this is a social event within the Caribbean, within the Jamaican community, that celebrates our independence. Our ball still remains the number one social event as far as the calendar is concerned within the Jamaican community here in the diaspora.
The ball is held again where?
At the New York Hilton, which is it has the largest ballroom right there in New York, right off Avenue of the Americas.
Right.
And you know,
across from is that big radio station?
Close, in that area. Right. And you know, it has become almost like the home for a ball, because we've been doing it now there for several years. Right. And they've worked well with us. And you know, we encourage those who are watching and listening to come out and participate. It's going to be a fantastic evening.
No, is there a contact number that people could call?
Sure, they can call the Jamaican Consulate at 212-935-9000. That's 212-935-9000.
One of the things that really strike me about the ball is the fact that you make money, but the money is spent back into Jamaica, back into the Jamaican community.
Yeah, well, I like to say the Caribbean community, because also some of that money is spent here in charity, right here in our communities. And, you know, a ball of this nature, of course, money is, you know, generated because we're a foundation. So, you know, it's not as if you're making profit. There's no profit here to be made. It's funds that are left over, basically, are distributed to charities. And that is something that we're very proud of. One of the main charities in Jamaica that benefits from this over the years have been the Maxfield Park Children's Home, which was a major recipient of contributions over the years. And of course, University of Weston is that, of, as you know, is one of our fundamentally sound education institutions within the Caribbean. and we are committed to that.
Well, so I have a list here. Missionaries of the Poor.
Yes.
Is one that you support. The Good Shepherd Foundation, right? New York Rescue Mission, founded by Jerry and Maria McCauley. New York City Rescue Mission has been serving city since 1872. Mm-hmm. How do you arrive at the Ward Foundation, the Alpha Boy School? How do you choose the charity
This is it. There's a plethora of organizations. It's never easy. It's never hard. You know they're there. So it's a matter of selecting. And basically, those organizations, too, that presents a factor, an indication that by them being supported at a given point, we'll get them to the next level. Because also, too, we look at organizations, too, that uses funds to, one would say, no, instead of giving the man fish, we give the man a line to go fish.
To go fish.
Yeah, the cottage industry and stuff like that. So, we're very proud of that, and we're looking forward for persons to come out and celebrate with us. And I must tell you before you break that there are several folks in the community who will be honored, and some of which are Ray Goldburn, who is an executive at the Black Entertainment Television Network. Funny I should start off with that, right? And of course we have Irie Jam Radio that has been providing media services here in the diaspora for over 20 years, and several others. So it's also a celebration and recognizing those who have done well within our community.
And no, taking you to Irie Jam, I can't have you mention Irie Jam and not mention the fact that you are you're part of that operation as well, and have a radio show. Is that?
Yeah, that's part of it, but rest assured, I had nothing to do with your honor.
No, of course not. I'm not even trying to suggest that. I'm
but knowing you,
No, you see,
Yes.
That's for Rickford to say. That's not for
you. I know.
Right,
but
for
Rickford. Rickford understands what I'm saying.
Right, but no, but I'm saying is, though, yes. But, I mean, these guys,
Robert Clark and Roy. DJ Roy and
the members, yes, have been at that forefront for a minute.
Yes.
And duly so, the recognition is quite, yes, quite understood.
Yes.
But now, again, give them the location.
Again, it's going to be at the Hilton Hotel.
And you're starting on time.
We have an elaborate cocktail hour that is more than an hour with a whole lot of food. And of course, the dinner is always, we have to have our Jamaican-ness in it,
Right.
Companies that are supporting us are many, are some of our homegrown companies.
Right.
Grace Kennedy, for example,
right,
is one of our main sponsors. Caribbean Food Delight, Tower Isles, Golden Cross.
Golden Cross,
these are some of the companies that are within the community, of the community. And of course, I must tell you this, that of course, the piece of Jamaica that we like to believe flies today, Fly Jamaica. Well, of course, it's instrumental here because they're the official carrier that carries in the band, which is Fab Five.
Fab Five.
So we're very happy
with
that.
Fab Five could put on a show.
Well, they are the number one Caribbean dance band right now.
Period.
Well, yeah.
Well, I mean, no, we can say
I'm
period.
On the show now, so I can say that.
Oh, yeah, because, yeah, right, yeah, right. But, I mean, we kind of know that. And people can get tickets by calling the mission and any place else?
Well, tickets are also available at VP Records at the Caribbean Foods Delight in Mount Vernon. But I'd urge folks to call 212-935-9000, and they'll be so informed as to where they can pick up their tickets.
Okay. I have to thank you very much for this, and I had to acknowledge Ms. Andrea Daly,
yes,
for setting this up and making sure that I am in the loop. I mean, I've been doing this for more than 25 years, just so that you know that. I mean, yes. I just mean.
And we expect to see you there, too. We expect to see you there. Tickets can be had by calling the consulate, and they'll tell you how much it is.
Oh, okay. All right. I'll call the consulate and make sure that my name is on the guest list. I'm coming in on Owens. I let them folk know that I'm coming in with my name on the Irwine Clare.
Yes, sir.
I'll be right there.
Okay.
So I'm going to take us out. I'm going to take us out of this segment by rolling a little video of a little taste of Jamaica, a little taste of one of those festival music from way back when. Several of the Jamaican stars are in there, and so if you could just roll tape on the beat, roll tape, please.
Now I'm an easy. Big up man like Josie Wales.
Oh, say nothing like the sweet
Shaggy
Jamaica.
Music na decide that I be my ya.
No.
I
be proud of me island. Lord of God, we say be proud of me island. Commissar Vegas, we proud of me island. Uncle Josie will be say me proud of me island.
On Caribbean Classroom, we're celebrating Jamaica's 51st independence, and our Times is leading this week with Jamaicans who influence American society. So while we're celebrating Jamaica, we know of people like Patrick Ewing, of people like Shaggy, we know of people like Monty Alexander in the jazz genre, and several others, Colin Powell, just to name a few. Marcus Garvey, well, I mean, they put him in jail here, so, you know, I don't know if America...
Marcus Garvey,
all right, so, okay, Marcus Garvey, period. So, I mean, as we celebrate Jamaica, I have to take you into my announcements. I always like to do that.
Sweet Jamaica.
September 10th, the New York City primary. If you don't know where you're supposed to vote, I'm not telling you who to vote for, but if you don't know where to vote or where your polling place is to vote, I'm encouraging you to call 1-866-VOTE-NYC. 1-866-VOTE-NYC. You want to check that out. I happened to stop out in Far Rockaway a couple evenings ago, last weekend, as a matter of fact, and I ran into the Rockaway Youth Task Force. And what these young people are doing out in Far Rockaway is remarkable. And so that they have their own green, green market that they've set up, and they're selling fresh. I said, where are you getting fresh fruits and vegetables from out in Far Rockaway? And they have hookups with these different farms that truck in the fruits and vegetables for them, and so they're able to create their own businesses.